My name is Davis Malombe. I work for the Kenyan Human Rights Commission as the Deputy Executive Director. The Commission has received the case of four Kenyans who are arbitrarily arrested, of course, and charged in South Sudan. And basically, we are very concerned about those kind of developments, because clearly these people did not go through a fair process. They were not subjected to a fair hearing. They were also not subjected to equal treatment before the law. And they have also been subjected to unfair administrative processes, which to us are a violation of the international and the regional human rights standards. For example, where states have obligations to protect and respect human rights for all citizens. So basically, we are condemning this kind of atrocities, because basically what these Kenyans have been subjected to, they have been subjected to framed up charges. When the matter even went to court, witnesses were threatened. They were not even given a chance to be represented by a competent lawyer. So what we are therefore demanding for is immediate and unconditional release of those citizens. And we are also requesting the government of Kenya through the president to use the same energies he has used to withdraw the soldiers from southern Sudan to also secure the release of Kenyans like yesterday. We have also discovered this has been a pattern of violations to Kenyans who are basically involved in different affairs in southern Sudan. For example, in our meeting in the morning, we were told that over 100 drivers, long-distance drivers, have been killed this year. And we have also received other complaints from other categories of Kenyans who have also been violated in many different ways. So apart from also dealing with these four cases, we are also asking the government of Kenya through the president to ensure that also these other issues, which are also emerging, touching on other citizens, are also taken care of. And also use its diplomatic channels to ensure that this issue of targeting Kenyans who are working with the South Sudan is a matter of the past. Because also the government of Sudan has to be held to account. Because in Kenya, we have so many people from that country who have received a lot of support and also a lot of protection from the local citizens. The ambassador is very, very simple, because she's seeking the position of the chair of the African Union. The challenge to her is if she cannot deal with the simple matters of national interest, touching actually on the rights of citizens of this country who are being violated in southern Sudan, then she has no basis going for those positions. So what we are challenging her is to intervene, because she was summoned by parliament through the leader of majority, Honorable Duale, where she indicated that those Kenyans are innocent and she was using her good office to secure her release. Since that commitment, we haven't seen any progress. So what we are challenging her to do is to use this case to showcase a capacity and a commitment to protect the interest and the right of citizens of Kenya and also of Africa at all levels. So if she cannot deal with this, then we think she's also going to be challenged dealing with bigger issues around regional and international interest.